हेलो स्टूडेंट, हेलो स्टूडेंट, अब क्लास 10। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व द क्वेश्चन नंबर 6 अब 3.3 अब 3.3 अरिथमेटिक प्रोग्रेशन। प्रीवियसली वी सॉल्व द फाइव एग्जाम्पल ऑफ द 3.3। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व द क्वेश्चन नंबर 6। आई विल रीड द क्वेश्चन 6। द सम ऑफ क्वेश्चन 6 3.3। द सम ऑफ द फर्स्ट 55 टर्म्स ऑफ एन एपी इज अ 3300। फाइंड द 28th टर्म। सो हियर SN इज गिवन। What is the first 55 term? Sum of first 55 means first 55 is what? 3300. Okay. Then find the 28th term. What we want to find? 28th term means T28, not SN, it is a T28. Okay. Find the 28th term. So we are going to solve it by using the formula SN is equal to 2A in bracket N by 2 in bracket 2A plus N minus 1 into D. This is our formula to calculate the value of SN. By using this formula, we are solving our question. So by putting the values here, N is what? 55. N value is of 55. So yes, 55. Yes, 55 is equal to what? N's value is of 55. 55 upon 2 into 2 into A. We does not know the value of A. Plus, what is the value of N again here? 55 minus 1 into D. We does not know the value of D. So by calculating it, 55 divided by 2 into, it will get multiplied to the each term of the bracket, it will into 2a. This 2 gone, who will remain here? 55a. And here is, this is a 55 minus 1, that is a 54, means 55 upon 2 into 54d. We directly write this step. 55 into 1, that is a 54d. Again, by dividing it, 2 1s are 2, 27 and 54. Therefore, we get 55 as a common and in a bracket, it will be A plus 27d. You take 55 as a common. 55 as a common from both. So 55 in bracket A plus 27B. We get the value of S 55. We get this value. We are considering it as the first. This is the first equation. Then what information is given there? Now we want to find out the 28th term. We want the find the 28th term. Means for that we are using the formula for Tn. Tn is equal to A plus N minus 1 D. Okay. T28 means N value is 28. N value is 28. So we are putting this value. And also remember in the last value we calculated. Then A plus N value is 28 minus 1 into D means is equal to A plus 28 minus 1, that is a 27d. That is the means we get the value of T28 is equal to A plus 27d. But previously we solved. Previously we have taken, we get the value of a value of SN is equal to 3300 is equal to 52 A plus 27. We get this value. Then, in this, we are dividing this 55 by 3300 by 55, it is a plus 27 d. By dividing it, we get 60 m. By dividing of 3300 divided by 55 is equal to 60, is equal to a plus 70 d. That is our equation number second. Look here, this a plus 27. Here is also present, here is also, suppose this is the equation number third. Here is also a plus 27 present, here is also 27 present. Means d28 is equal to a plus 27 d. What is the value of a plus 27 d we calculated here? It is a 60. So t28, we get the value of t20 is what? A plus 27, but value of a plus 27 is what? 60. So we get the value of our 28th term is what? 60. 28th term is what? 60. Understood? By using the calculation of our SM and the formula TM, we are obtaining the value of T28. Okay? Then, question number 7. Then, question number 7. I have read the question number 7. Question number 3.3. In an AP, the sum of the three consecutive terms is a 27 and their product is a 504. Find the terms. Conditions दी है उसमें. अभी हमको क्या करने का उसको? Find out करने का है. What is the condition की बात? Three consecutive terms. Means एक के बाद एक जो terms आते हैं उनको क्या बोलते हैं? Consecutive term. So we are considering the consecutive term starting from for our adjustment, it will be taken as a minus d, means a and the difference. Then uske baad a minus d and plus d gone, means only a remain, and next term is a plus d. The fixed constant difference or common difference we are adding, but we are first taking it as a minus d, then next term is a, and then a plus d. We are adding the d. These are the three consecutive terms. These are our three consecutive terms. Okay? These are the three consecutive terms. Then, according to a condition, the sum of the three consecutive terms is what? 27. The sum of these three. A minus D, this sum is added with A plus D, itino ki sum. First, second and third. Unki sum according to a given things. What is given here? 27. Here is it. Okay? Then D minus D and D different signs. So it will get cancelled. A plus A 3 times means 3A is equal to what? 27. So 3 get on right hand side, it will get divided. So 3 was a 3 9. Therefore, we get the value of A is equal to what? 9. We get the value of A is equal to what? We write here for our term. Okay. Then we want to find out the value of a next term. Value of the next. What is the condition given in the next term? What is the condition is given? The product is tino ka. Jo product hoga. Means A consecutive term. A minus B. Then A and A plus B. Unka product kitna hai? 5000 and 4. According to that condition, this is also given thing. Then we solve it, we close these two terms, A minus D, A plus D, and A is equal to 504. We know the formula, 5, one time addition and one time subtraction. So we are writing A, or we are putting the value of A. We get the value of A here. What is that? 9. So instead of A, we are writing 9 here. 9 minus D. We does not know the difference. Then, here is a 9 plus D. And A's value is a 9. Is equal to 504. Then, this 9 goes to that side. So it will get divided. Means 9 minus D. 9 plus D. Is equal to 504 divided by 9. And the division is what? 56. That division is what? 56. So 9 minus b and 9 plus b, both are the same term. We are using the formula x plus a and x minus a, or x plus a y, x minus y, that is equal to x square minus y square. Therefore, it is the first term, that is their square. Here is the second term, their square is equal to what? 56. 9 square is what? 81 minus b square is equal to what? 56. Is equal to what? 56. So we bring it here. 81 minus b square minus, we are changing the side, minus b square is got on that side, it will become plus, and 56 come on the left hand side, means 81 minus 56 and minus b square become a plus by changing the sides. Okay, 81 minus 56. 81 minus 56. What is that? 25. Is equal to what? D square. 25 is equal to D square. So we are taking the square root of D. Therefore, 25 is a perfect square up to 5. But we are taking the, when we are taking the square root, we get the two values, plus and minus 5. So value of D is equal to plus 5 and value of D is equal to minus 5. Here we get the value of D, 1 plus 5 and as well as minus 5. Because when we are taking a square root, we get the two values. Because 5 square is a 25 and minus 5 square is also a 25. So we get the value of A, D. So we are finding the next one, which are these terms. So by putting again, which are the consecutive terms? A minus D, A plus D. So first we put the value of D is equal to 5 and A is equal to, so we have to get 9. So 9 minus 5, D is a 5. Here is A means 9 and A plus D means 9 plus 5. So 9 minus 5, that is a 4, 9, and 9 plus 4 is a 14. It is our first set of that consecutive, first set of that consecutive number. We are taking the value of D. Minus 5. Value of D, this is the plus square of a consecutive term. Then, by taking the value of D is equal to what? Minus 5. In the same, D is equal to minus 5. So, A is equal to 9 minus, this is minus, so you take a minus bracket. A is a 9 and A plus, it is minus value, so it will take in a bracket. A's value is a 9, A's value is a 9. So, 9 minus minus become plus 5. Here is a 9. Here is a 9. Plus minus is a minus. Minus means 14. 9 and again 4. These are the second value of the three consecutive term. So we solve the question number 7. We solve the question number 7. Three consecutive terms are 4. 9.